for the week of November 1st.
Hello, I'm Tyson, and who are you?
I am Mr. Dibble.
I'm going to be asking three questions for this school so far. What do you teach for so far right now?
I teach 6th grade science and history.
What do you like for the school so far?
I just like getting to know all these new people. It's my first year here, and there's a lot of new faces and a lot of new personalities.
What memory from other schools do you teach?
Well, I was at my last school for 12 years, and I would say that my favorite memories were watching the kids grow up. They'd start in like preschool at 2 and 3 years old, and then I'd have them in 5th grade.
Cool. Thank you for your time, Mr. Dibble, and have a good day.
Okay, so hi, it's Ms. Jacobs. I know that LTE, the data, has not been working very well on Chromebooks. A lot of you are struggling to connect. So here's what we're going to do. Today in advisory, you should be getting this sheet from your teacher. Some of you already filled it out. We're gonna do it again now because the problems with the LTE. Go home tonight, follow these instructions, log into your device, log into your student account, and then you're only supposed to check two of these boxes, not all four. Either your device connects to your home Wi-Fi or doesn't, and either your device has LTE service at home or it doesn't. So let me know. Your advisory teacher is gonna collect these from you tomorrow. We're gonna get hotspots to people that need them. So please take this home, please do this tonight. Turn it back into your advisory teacher tomorrow. We'll get you all hooked up to Wi-Fi, okay?
Now let's see the students of the month for October. Congratulations to all winners. Your prizes will be delivered tomorrow during advisory.
My name is Mola. I'm going to be giving you some rules and tips and a way how to get daylight savings done easier. Daylight savings is the practice of turning the clock ahead as warmer weather approaches and back as it becomes colder again. A way how to make daylight savings easier for you is by deciding to go to bed earlier, which is obvious. Enjoy the longer evenings, exercise, and reduce screen time. All right, that's all today. Remember to change your alarms and wake up early for school.
November 2nd is Stress Awareness Day. Let's learn more.
Today is Dia de los Muertos. Let's learn more through a short presentation by our very own Eric Mowers.
Last week there was the soccer intramural championship. Congratulations to the Brick Wall for a well-deserved victory. Let's now go to our sports reporter for more.
Team name?
Brick Wall FC.
How do you guys think you're going to perform today?
Really good.
Do you have anything you want to say to the other teams?
That we're ready for you guys. We're just like, we're ready.
Guys, team name?
Unknown FC.
How do you think you're going to perform today?
Hopefully good. Hopefully good.
Yeah. Do you think you have anything to say to the other teams?
Get ready because we're on fire.
Ooh.
I'm gonna be super cliche and say my family and friends. I'm so grateful for them, especially the last few years.
Thank you. Ms. Mara, what are you grateful for?
I'm grateful for my health, my home, and my family.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Miguel.
What are you grateful for?
My family.
Okay, thank you.
Chloe,
what are you grateful for?
I am grateful for my family and my cats and my rabbit.
Alright, thank you.
Maria, what are you grateful for?
I'm grateful for Tanya.
Thank you.
What is your name?
Nathan.
Nathan, what are you grateful for?
I'm grateful for my family.
Thank you. Mr. Mahon, what are you grateful for?
I'm grateful right now that it's fall, and during fall at McDonald's, they have the McRib sandwich. So I am grateful right now that I get a chance to get a McRib sandwich. I know they're terrible for me. I feel bad about myself after I eat one of them, but they're good. So I'm grateful for the McRib. Thank you.
Okay. Isaiah, all right,
what are you grateful for?
No. You said all right. Wait, what are you grateful for?
I'm grateful that my family is happy and healthy.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Elliot, what are you grateful for?
My friends, family, and
happiness. Miss Richard, what are you grateful for?
I'm grateful for so many things. One of the things I'm grateful for is my health, the health of my family. I'm also grateful for my job, that I have a roof over my head, and food to eat. So I'm grateful for my life.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We hope everyone had a safe and happy Halloween night. Let's take a look at some costumes from yesterday.
Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek.
We're so sorry, skeletons, you're so misunderstood. You only want to socialize,
but I don't think we should.
A spooky, scary skeleton shouts startling, shrilly screams. They'll sneak under sarcophagus and just won't leave you be. Scary.
We still need teams for intramural football. Games will start once we have a minimum of 5 teams signed up. Look in Ms. Hernandez's office window for the link to sign up.
Joe Musgrove has gone 8 2/3 and is an out away. The Friar faithful stand as one in Texas. Ground ball to shortstop. Kim will go to first. The San Diego Padres get their first no-hitter in the history of the franchise. And it belongs to San Diego's own Joe Musgrove, sending the Friar faithful.
No.
Popped up. Gonna be a long run. Oh, what a play! And he goes into the dugout. Can he hold on? Yes, he did. Oh, what a play! Urshela without any for Gio Urshela.
Baez hits it on the ground to third. Gonzalez.
So good.
Oh my goodness. Wow, you got to be kidding me. You've got to be
they
kidding me.
They stole a run. You have got to be kidding me. Javi Baez.
Keep going. Go. Think you're invisible.
El Mago indeed.
The Cubs have scored an unbelievable.
Baez not quitting on the play.
Into center field. Hamilton.
Whoa!
A make your own slip and slide for Billy Hamilton. Come on.
Gonzalez is 0-1. Swat at the right center field. Diving play. A walk-off catch. Mookie magic. The Dodgers 2, the Padres nothing. They've taken the first two out of 19 in 2021.
From your days in Little League, you are first taught on defense to think, what am I going to do if the ball is hit to me? Well, Mookie Betts.
Most people eat me, and that is no surprise. I taste great as chips, and also as bread. What am I?
A potato.
Yes, you got it right.
Goat.
All right, most people eat me, and this is no surprise. I taste great as chips, and also as bread. What am I?
As fries?
Uh-huh.
All fries?
No, you get two more tries.
A Cheetos?
Nope. You get one more try.
Takis?
Nope. Most people eat me and this is no surprise. I taste very as chips and also as fries. Where am I?
Doritos?
No, you get two more fries.
I don't know.
Alright. Most people eat me, that is no surprise. I taste great as chips and also as fries. What am I?
A potato.
Yes. Most people eat me and that is no surprise. I taste great as chips and also as fries. What am I?
An apple.
No, you get two more tries.
A carrot.
No, you get one more try.
A gummy bear.
No, most people eat me and that is no surprise. I taste great as chips and also as fries. What am I?
A potato. That's super easy. Come on, guys. Do the other one.
Eat me and that is no surprise. I taste great as chips and also as fries. Where am I?
Chips. Potato.
Yeah, correct.
We still need students to play on our 6th, 7th grade after school girls basketball team. Please see Mr. Johnstone for more information.
Yeah, so girls basketball, we had our first game yesterday. It was a tough game. It was a learning experience. Nobody got hurt, so that's always a positive thing. And we're looking forward to our next game. Just a note for the 6th and 7th graders still out there. We still have room on our 6th and 7th grade team. The 8th grade team is full. We got enough players for 8th grade. But 6th and 7th grade, we still need about 3 or 4 girls to complete our team, even more. So if you're interested, come see me. We can get you out practicing. We'll get you a permission slip, get you out practicing, and we'll get you out by our next game, which will be next Thursday, November 3rd.
Starting a project that is requiring an interview of every student at Shepherd. That's right, we are trying to get every single student to answer a single question, and we would like to do this class by class. Please email Ms. Jacobs with a good day to come and interview your second period class. Thank you ahead of time as we work on this exciting project.
Hello.
My name is Andy Cow again, and this time I'm telling you guys that the trimester is ending pretty soon. November 10th is when the trimester ends, the first trimester. Turn in all your work, do all of it supposed to be turned in before November 8th or 9th. Oh yeah, also November 10th, that's when everything ends, but there might be a cutoff. I don't know what that means. Basically, like trimester might go further. This is just a small announcement. Nothing to worry about unless your grade is 70 below. Worry a lot. All right, I'm good.
On the morning of November 11th, there will be a Veterans Day parade in downtown San Jose. This is a great opportunity to learn more about our nation's veterans and see a cool show. Look online for more information.
Thank you for listening to this week's announcements. I'm Aaron.
And I am Ryan.
And we are signing off.